Today we're taking a look at the 7360 Autophix Professional Scan Tool. We're just going to go ahead and get this thing unboxed and show you some of the features on it. Of course, it comes in the basic blister packaging here. Flip it upside down. You can see this is on the back of the packaging, and they have several different models here. This one is the 7360, and it is for the Toyota series of vehicles. You got your owner's manual and the unit itself here, as well as the probably charging cord slash plug into your computer. But other than that, pretty straightforward. All right, so we have the 7360 plugged into the car. We're going to just go ahead and scroll over and select Toyota. And here's your navigation keys right here. I won't show those the whole time. It's pretty self-explanatory. I just want to make sure you can see the screen. So we're going to go over to for Toyota. There we have. Wait 1 minute after the engine's been running, which it has been. So we're going to go ahead and select OK. We do have a Toyota, so we're going to select Toyota and North America. And then it's going to come up with a list of vehicles.
And then just scroll down, you can see there's several options here. There's 37 different ones. Camry and South Corolla, Echo FJ, Creo Cruiser.
And then, of course, there we are with the Highlander. So we're going to go ahead and select Highlander because that's what we're in. We do have a smart key with this car, so we're going to go ahead and select that. There's the vehicle information. Now we can do a full system scan, a manual select, or a special function. So a full system scan will scan everything. Manual scan will be able to choose the different areas we want to scan. For example, I'll just choose engine so you can see that. And that tells you what this is going to be looking for if we scan that section. Okay, so from here we have read fault codes, erase fault codes, or data stream. We're going to go ahead and just read fault codes. And it says we have a camshaft position sensor issue, so that's something we can look into. Looks like there's two, so we can go down. And we also have a stability malfunction. So that's something we can look into, and you can look that up to find out exactly what those codes mean if your car comes up with those codes. That's for this particular car here. That could be different for you, or you may have no codes at all. Then you can go in and erase the codes, and you can also look at the data stream. We're going to show that a little bit later. Last but not least in this section, you have special functions as well. And every vehicle is going to be different. You know, you have different options, features, and things like that on the vehicle. And some of these may be available to your vehicle, and some may not. So this scan tool has capability of reading multiple different things on a vehicle. But not every vehicle has all of the things that it can read. And once this loads up here, I'll give you a good example. You can see we have a lot of things we can read. Powertrain, throttle, oil reset. If you look at that one, it says diesel particulate filter. So I am currently sitting in a 2011 Toyota Highlander that runs on gasoline. So I do not have diesel in this vehicle, which also means I don't have a diesel particulate filter. So for this car, that particular feature would not be very useful. But if you have a Toyota with a diesel engine, then that might be something you could use to make sure your filter is not plugged and things like that. So I'm just trying to give you an example that this thing can scan a lot more than maybe your car has or does not have. So keep that in mind when you're using this tool, but it does have a lot of different things that you can check with this thing. Then we can go back to the beginning, go into the oil reset button. And if you select that, you just follow the process to reset your oil. I actually have trouble with this particular car. There is an issue with the oil reset system. But what you're supposed to do, you just follow these steps on here. It'll tell you how to do it. Then you can go into the electronic parking brake reset. Now, my car is not equipped with that, but if yours was, you can certainly go through that as well. Toyota, North America, just walks you through all that, and then it would reset that for you. But this vehicle does not have electronic parking brake, so it obviously can't do that. And again, that's going to change depending on vehicle models, makes, and what is available with those vehicles. I will just select one of these so you can see right away what it does, but in my case, it says it does not support it. So if you have a vehicle that has electronic parking brakes, this would be another feature you can use to reset it. So just keep that in mind. Every vehicle is going to be a little bit different. We can go into battery check. Pretty self-explanatory. This will check the voltage and wants us to turn the car off. So we're going to do that. We're going to push OK. And then it's going to tell us to start the car. And what it's going to do is read the power of the battery. Go ahead and start that up. There we go. So it dropped down during the startup. You can see that little graph there. And right now it's currently operating at 13.5 volts. So just kind of another thing you can check to see the health of your battery in your vehicle as well. And you can go into the BMS reset. Tells you the weight with smart key. Communicating with the vehicle now. If you would do automatic transmission or a valve body replacement, this is when you would want to reset this. Now, that has not been done in this vehicle, but this is another thing you can use to reset those functions so it can read correctly when you have a new system in your vehicle. And that's going to go pretty much the same for the next thing as well, I believe. The ETC reset. Yeah, it's telling us to reset memory. It says required to reset this if you've done automatic transmission or valve body replacement. And it's telling us to wait 45 seconds. So it just says to complete it, then you'd have to turn the vehicle off, restart it, and then drive it, and then stop. And that completes the reset process. Then we can go into the OBD2 scanner here. We can have it read codes for us. So let's go ahead and select that. You can see it's got a bunch of stuff here. It's scanned, read codes. This vehicle has no fault codes. So we reset stuff. So that's good. So we can do escape. If it were to have some codes, we can go in here and erase them. So clear, reset any emission related diagnostic information. Are you sure? And you can say yes and go ahead and do that. I don't have any. You can also go through the IM readiness, which in this drive cycle, to see if it's ready to pass inspection, emission controls, inspection, stuff like that. And it's really talking right down through all these things here. And it can scan all those and tell you, you can see where it says off to the right whether they're okay or not, but it'll let you know if you have any issues that need to be addressed. Keep in mind, some of these may not say okay unless you're actually operating the vehicle for some time. Depends on, yeah, like right this oxygen sensor monitor inconclusive. That's because the vehicle has to be up to temperature and running, and you need to drive it around to make sure it goes through all of these tests correctly. But another great feature if you want to make sure the vehicle good to go to get inspection. You can also go in, you see it has a data stream section, view all items. You can select items and you can see here, we'll just this is current data. If I can find, say, okay, engine RPM, you can see right there it is 600 roughly, and that's revolutions per minute. If I give it a little gas, you can see it shoots right up 1300. So this is live feed from the engine currently, and you can see our vehicle speed is zero. So a lot of great information there as well. Intake temperature is 51 degrees, all kinds of useful stuff if you're trying to do some diagnostic work on your vehicle. Now you can also do an evap system test. We can go ahead and choose that. It actually says evaporator system test leak, it failed. So I must have an issue somewhere. So that might be something I have to take a look at. I don't know if the test failed or it failed because there's a leak. That's a good question. And then, of course, vehicle information. So you can see this unit does have a lot of different things that you can do with it and do diagnostic work. So hopefully you found this video a little helpful. If you're looking to get a OBD2 scanner, then this might be the one for you, especially if you have a Toyota or a Toyota class of vehicles. It has a whole list of them that this will work with. So keep that in mind. It has lots of great features. Again, it's going to vary depending on the vehicle you have. I mean, I've tested a lot of these in the past, quite a few, and I like some better than others. This one seems pretty good. It's not going to work on every vehicle in your yard, though. So if you have a lot of different vehicles, then you might want to get something that's a little bit more universal. However, if you want something more specific to your vehicle, check out Autophix, because they do have other models of this device that will scan other makes and models of cars. So I'll put a link in the description for this one here, and or their site, where you can check out the different tools they have. And it's Autophix, and this is the 7360 used for the Toyota class of vehicles. I hope you like this video. Please like and subscribe. Come back often for more videos. Have a great day, and we'll see you in the next one.